substance.
And when it leaks into, and when it leaks into
your mother earth, your mother, whatever that torture, that blood,
whether it was a murder,
she feels that. That is, she tortures.
Death lies ahead for each one of us. If we fear death, then we must also fear life. If we do not accept death, our own death, then we cannot accept life. For death is as much a part of existence as life itself. We are born, we live, and we shall die. It is our nature to die. Death lies ahead for each one of us. We are at this very moment both living and dying. If we are uneasy about death, our death, then we must, as we live, be uneasy about life, our life. How we see death, our death, is crucial to how we live our lives. We may argue that there is nothing after death, and that nobody has ever come back. But if we see the end of our bodies as the end of us, then we must see death as either an escape from life, or as the ultimate futility. The one a fear of life, the other a fear of death, and both a fear of existence. But the truth is that we feel that we are immortal, and we all believe in our own immortality. That there is an existence after death that personally concerns us, each one of us. The truth is that none of us can imagine ourselves not existing. But we fear death. The whole subject is uncomfortable for us, to say the least. We feel uncomfortable in the presence of someone who is dying. We find it difficult to comfort such a person when we ourselves feel such a fear of death. Death is often a tragedy for us, even though it may be a blessing to the one who is dying. Death takes our loved ones from us, or us from our loved ones. Death must be avoided. We must live longer and stay younger. Death is the enemy who overtakes us. We feel that the dead are death's victims. We fear death as a young child fears to go into the dark. But more of our fear of death is our fear of misusing the life given to us as we have it. And our fear of arriving at the point of death with regrets, a sense of futility, of wrong, of waste, with feelings of failure, dissatisfaction, and unfulfillment. For in reality, when there is no guilt for a life misused, there is no fear of death. When there is no guilt for a life misused, there is no fear of death. Death is our constant companion, always with us, waiting. If we fear death, we fear ourselves. But if we come to accept easily and gracefully the inescapable fact that one day we will die, and never forget this, then we can have a fulfilling and happy life, even in the face of great adversity. We live surrounded by death, by the agents of death, violence, war, crime and corruption, competition, the rape of our polluted planet, famine, disease, all kinds of disasters. What is there to give our lives a meaning and purpose? What hope is there in a world filled with despair? How can it be possible to die in peace when we live so sadly? How is it possible to come to terms with death, which threatens us so? There is only one way through. Though it may take many forms, we must discover, somehow, in our lives, the permanence of our spirit. That is to say, the real us. Over death and through death into rebirth. Death is the gateway to life.